So from the dhikr of Allah, which is one of the greatest acts of ibadah to perform as a Muslim, is alhamd, is to praise Allah, and ash-shukr, to thank Allah, and at-tasbih, to believe and to declare Allah's perfectness and Allah's perfection. Subhanallah, Allah is perfect. That which you say about Allah isn't true. That which you believe about Allah isn't right, because Allah is too perfect to have a son. He's too perfect to take a rest after He created the heavens and the earth. He's too perfect to have made this mistake, or whatever the people say about Allah Azza wa Jal. Wassalamun ala al-mursaleen. Allah Azza wa Jal, He negated what the people said about Him, but not the messengers. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Al-mushrikun, al-kafirun, al-munafiqun, ashab al-aqa'id al-batila. Wassalamun ala al-mursaleen. Lisalamati man qaluhu. Allah, He says, Subhana rabbika. Your Lord, Muhammad, is too far from that which they say about Him. They can never catch up to Allah's perfection. They can't catch up to Allah's greatness. Because the word Subhana comes from Sabaha, yani Ada, fil Jari. It means something that's very fast and something that's far beyond. When people are racing and running, and someone is so athletic and so fast that the people are way behind him, they can barely catch up to him. This is what the word Subhana linguistically means. So Allah Azza wa Jalla is too perfect for them to catch up to His greatness. Those who say He has a son, and those who say this about Him and that about Him. So Allah said, Your Lord, O Muhammad, Subhana Rabbika, He's too beyond what they say about Him. And peace be upon the messengers, because what they said about Him was the truth. What they said about it, Allah Azza wa Jalla, was the haqq.